traders in Kabuga Market, which hosts buyers from Kigali and in the near suburbs, say since the suspension of travel between the city of Kigali and the district due to the COVID-19 pandemic, they lack where to purchase food commodities. I used to get a bus, then go to the eastern province to purchase commodities, but now I can't. We used to buy beans at 300 or 250 Rwandan francs, but now it's 500 Rwandan francs per kilo. Because travel between districts and Kigali were banned, they changed prices anyhow. They sent commodities only after we sent the money. Beans and maize reduced on the market. This will affect both traders and the customer. Since now is the harvesting time, prices should have reduced, but it didn't happen. People used passenger buses to carry sacks of beans and groundnuts, but that happens no more. Even if one vehicle comes, it carries 20 sacks, and you have to distribute them amongst all the traders. We are worried that we will lack goods when our stock gets finished. These traders share the issue with their colleagues in Nyarugenge Market, who said vehicles that brought food commodities to Kigali and went back with other commodities have reduced. Yes, goods can cross, but customers are few. Normally, traders would use public buses, but now it's one driver and the trader in a vehicle. Because of this, the trader takes few commodities. Cargo truck drivers say people would come to purchase goods in Kigali by their own, but now some have stopped because one cargo truck cannot exceed two people. If a person has money, there is no way to purchase commodities. Before, traders would use cargo transportation vehicles to carry some products, but since those trucks were no longer there, it's difficult. Vehicles that transport food products are not restricted. We go anywhere freely. The Minister of Trade and Industry, Soraya Hakuzyeremye, says although commercial vehicles are allowed to travel, traders can use technology to pay for goods without going out of Kigali. We have not restricted cargo trucks. Commodities can reach the market like it used to be. No one should hike prices. Secondly, we carry out inspections in partnership with local authorities, Rwanda Revenue Authority, and security organs. We are going to increase the inspection to fight those who want to hike prices owing it to the COVID-19 prevention guidelines. The current COVID-19 prevention strategy requires businesses, shops, restaurants and markets to close by 6 p.m.